Hey Don here. Okay, ready to install my new side splash. I'm not gonna try to get it in there that good because I'm gonna do a close up. The new side splash is ready for installation, and it looks like the video, my close up is going the wrong way, so let's stop it. Hey, you don't hear? Okay, the new side splash is ready for installation. I've got all the edges sanded up, and I'm trying to show the edge there. It's not too bad now. You can still, you might be able to see it in the video. There's a little bit of that line between the old and new finish, you know, the original and mine. But this is, didn't want to go through the. I did go through a hair right there, more than her hair, but I think a lot of that will be covered up with my caulking. Actually, I'll probably just purposely cover it up, because one of the main reasons I wanted to do that was to look for looks, but I didn't want caulking. I even sprayed the backside so that water, I mean, I don't want caulking, I don't want water seeping in there. And I want to make a little coffee, so I got my coffee thing. Actually, that's for me to dip my paper towels in when I use water and paper towels to get a nice edge. This is the big wide one that I made, the backsplash. It's been installed for 2 weeks, a month now. Been waiting on that side splash. I don't know if you can see that, but that was a pretty big gap and I had it filled out. I'll probably go across that with some caulking again, maybe. Yeah, right there, it's sunk in a little. So it shrinks when it dries, so I'll fill that back in. And that's a little wet. I splash a lot. So I'm going to wipe it down. Again, I've already dried this some, but I'm going to make sure it's good and dry. Start installing. And I'm just using, I've got to get this, punctured and ready to go. I'm just using latex white caulking. I can't get that to spin, but it's the 35-year warranty acrylic latex. This is DAP brand, but I finally got to where I write the date on it because it stays out in the garage for years, and sometimes if it goes through a freeze, this is good. I've used it. I just used it. It's 0915, but when it gets, if it goes through, if it ever gets frozen, it's ruined, and what it'll do is it just, it won't dry. It won't. It'll still look okay. If it starts stinking and smelling sour, get rid of it. A lot of times you can't tell by anything, but just by putting it on. And a lot of times, if it's old and I'm not sure how good it is, then I'll put it on a cardboard box in the garage or in the inside the trash can out there and let it see if it's going to dry. But this is all right. So anyway, let me go in here. I got my wide shot over there. I meant to get everything all ready to go. Let me get this right off. I gotta get my. Well, I got a nail. I didn't. I don't know if you did. A nail or a screw will keep you a good path between uses. If you didn't already know that, as if most people, anybody that's ever actually done any caulking should already know that. You can always put something in there, a stick or something. Those caps, you know, they're great, but. Thing they don't do is they don't stop it from drying up down the tube, and then you've got to dig and dig and dig. So actually, just a nail or a screw does me better service. I'm drying that because I'm going to go ahead and hit that with caulking. Well, maybe not the top, but I'm going to hit this one here. That's the one that really gets the most water, and it shrunk back a little bit when it dried, so I'm wiping it. I'm getting some of that thin layer of caulk that I didn't know was still there. But yeah, I'm going to hit that, but first I'm getting this in there. Okay. But I thought I'd get it now because I don't want to forget it. And I want it to be dry. So, you know, it's hard to kind of rub, I mean, I'll I'll show how I do it. I was taught this technique back in early 80s. And it works really well, and just don't overdo the water. And it works well. But use a wet rag or a paper towel to get a nice edge. It hasn't been too long since I used this, so. I knew I wanted that lid. I used that lid to lay that in. If you can see it, but that's the lid to the coffee can. I knew I wanted it for something. I was laying my paper towels on it. Now, I don't think it's dry up yet since the last use, so I think I'm going to be able to just start. Now, what I'm going to do is start. Where am I aimed? I just bumped into everything. Okay, I'm going to start on the back. This is going in here like this. And, yeah, I can see my spot where I goofed up and got through the new finish. But I'm going to put some on here. And I'm going to put some on here. I'll put a little on the back first. Make sure it's squirting out good. Put it down close to the edge. So that it will... Yeah, I've got enough. I was kind of worried about having enough. I just kept meaning to really just go ahead and buy another one, and I kept forgetting. Always push, don't pull, to get your, when you want a nice edge. Won't really matter a lot if you're just putting some on there, but I'm going to let that squeeze it out. Then I'll go to making it pretty. Put pressure on it to squeeze all that stuff on the back. Good. Because of the way this sink, it's actually the edges are higher in it, and it's not level, so that it will drain, which is great. But it's going to cause me to have more area to caulk too. Just want to make sure I don't leave it sticking out too far away from the, since I put that on the back like I did. Okay, I think that's as far in any direction as it's gonna go. Last time I wore some, I'm getting caulked in this brand new sink. We don't want that. Last time I wore some gloves. You know what? I think I have one in my back pocket. That would be nice to, I guess if I turn that, get that pressure off the lid, it would stop leaking so badly. Let's see. A couple new paper towels ready. From over here. Okay, now. Yeah, that'll be nice for me there. I have one glove. I never used to wear gloves. They didn't even have these back when I was a cabinet maker. If they did, I didn't know about it. But yeah, that one glove will keep me from getting quite as dirty. I don't like digging that stuff out from under my fingernails if I don't have to. So I gotta get with it. Remember to turn that off each time. forgot to do this front. It's kind of tricky because I have this dry up there to that routed edge, but I'm just going to have to get it all over it and then wipe it out. You don't want to get too much out at once. Be able to wipe it before it gets too hard to work. There's my magnifying glass. That's not helping. I can't see. see it all that good anymore, so. I've learned to rely on my magnifying glass. There's gonna be a spot in there where it's just gonna have to be in my, it's gonna have to be in there. Touch it up after that dries up a little bit. Once you get rid of the excess, you can start making it look nice. Just wipe it really lightly with your finger, around part of your finger, and you want to. Don't want your paper towel to be, don't be, just throw it away when it's dirty. You don't want it to be all wadded up. You want it to be or too thick, because then it won't go around your finger good to make a nice edge. And since there's lots of water going to be splashed on there, I'm going to worry more about sealing it than I am about it. Well, not, it's a thick, a little bit thick there. Now, there's that spot where I went right through my gel coat. So I'm going to leave that caulking on top of it. That's a little thicker there than I want. So it's really tricky to get right when you're on a wood edge like that. And I found an air pocket. It's tempting to wipe it with the glove itself, but usually that messes it up. There we go, get the air pocket. Better to use your paper towel usually. Shoot. If you get it all wrapped right. If not, go back over it again and again. Sometimes you get worse than where you started. But you can usually can fix it if you just keep working at it. I've still got a little spot there with burn through. I have a feeling that's going to be really hard to cover up. And so even, you know, you really can rub off extra spots like that white right up there, if you can see that, after it dries, but it's not always real easy either, so just gonna have to judge how much you really want to wipe across it. There we go. Now I've got a little bit of caulking on my thing. I'm trying to leave some behind on that spot. But I have a little bit. There's a little on the end of my deal that I want to get and use here. But work it into that. It's nice to get it done all in one thing, but if you have to, you can always come back later once it dries and fix it up even better. Okay. Which I cut mine on an angle. If you can see that or not. It works good for me most of the time. Yeah, there you go. I don't just cut it straight off the end. Sometimes, like especially down at the bottom there, since I was wiping up on the top, the water will build up down there. So you gotta make sure you kind of, you can just use the caulking gun to push it away. Put a little more caulk in there. See, there's a lot of space under there, so I'm gonna make sure it's full. you try to make it, that's the idea of pushing, is you're pushing it into your gap. That's why pushing works better than pulling. Sometimes I'll use that extra that's on there to wipe it back into place, but that would make a big mess, and I'm not going to do it right there. Just try to make sure you don't wipe with a dirty rag, because then it'll be wiping all over your sink or whatever it is you're caulking. And if you notice I didn't use any liquid nails or anything to hold that up there. I used to, but I figured out over the years that that caulking hole is just about as good, if sometimes better, than liquid nails. And liquid nails is really thick and hard to work. So, like the way I was pushing that in, you know, to get it flush up against the cabinet, can't hardly do it with liquid nails. And the main reason, honestly, is my liquid nails dried up. I had a big old tube of it, and I thought I was good on liquid nails. But I'm actually now glad that I'm not using it. Making a mess. It's actually looking pretty good on the bottom. But I can't find a clean spot. There. I get this little spot right here. I get it good and then I get it messed up again. So I better leave well enough alone. After it's had a little time to settle in just a little bit, you can hit it again with your wet rag, but you may do that. So usually once you get it pretty good, you ought to leave it alone. My worry is that I know I can't see that good. I'm always worried I'm missing something. Make it worse. Yeah, I'll do that, and then I'll go up across here, and I'll hit that, because that's got a little water in there. It needs to be. Needs a chance to settle, dry out, drain out a little bit. There we go. I like to make it pretty as I can, but sometimes all you do is slip and make a mess. Once it dries, you really don't, especially if you can't see good like me, you don't see the little imperfections. Okay, I'm figuring this is going to do just like this part up here did. It's going to shrink back a lot. Not sure, you know, that's so nice there. It may be shrunk back, but it really looks pretty good. I'm not going to put any more in it. I think it'll just look worse. Just going to do the top, because I don't want water to be able to set in that crack and try to seep in. Miss some of it. That was on in my pocket. The way this white is, it reflects light and I can't see what I've done and what I haven't done. Okay, hit this again. air bubble. Okay, let's fold that completely in half. Gonna work that corner again. Another air bubble. This time I'm gonna hit it with the glove. Oops. The glove has more of a tendency to wipe it out of there, I think, than the paper towel does. A lot of the times, anyway. Well, I'm gonna have to add some. Just wipe it out on me. Sometimes you want to make it go back into a place where you wipe some out by accident. A bunch of extra there. And then I'm going to have to try to fix in a second with a brand new paper towel. Okay. I'm going to leave that corner like that. Now I gotta fix that. And I really want to get a little bit on top of that while I sand it through, and I'm not sure how I'm gonna get that to happen. Let me get this first. Oh, it's really bad about wiping out of there. I mean, the water can't go up that hill anyway, but I was doing it for the looks. Fold it up. This right here is turning into the hard part. If I wipe that way, then I get it all over the wood. And it seems like every time I wipe that way, it just wipes it smooth out of there. Okay. Okay. Actual finger will usually do a better job than a glove, and if you are going to wipe with just a finger, and I might have to do that here in that spot. If you can't get to do it with the messed all up, I'm trying to fix it. If you can't get it to do it with the paper towel and your glove, then not go back to the old fashioned way. Oh, that was dried too much. That is the good thing about using the wet paper towel, though. You can get a new one. If you don't wait too long, you can still scrub it out with the wet paper towel. That's why you don't put out too much at once. Which I just pushed the limit. Well, I did have too much out of it. Hitting that corner, fooling around with that corner while this was sitting over here beginning to dry. Didn't realize how long I was fooling around. Okay, let's see. Pretty tricky. Okay, the gloves are off. Throw that away. I can't do any fine tuning without my real finger. There. Yeah, that's much better. So even though, you know, if you don't like getting dirty, maybe you better just get over it if you want to do the thing. Do the good work. Your finger is a much better tool than a wood glove. Or a paper towel. Alright, now I'm going to put a little bit more on there. One more time. Let's see if I can work it in with my finger. I can feel it too. I know what's going where. Yeah, that's much better. It's going to be sunken in a little, no matter what I do. But once it dries, if I'm not happy with it, I can always add a little more, because then it'll let you do it. So I'm going to quit fouling it up and fixing it over and over again and leave it like that. best there. I'm really using a lot of paper towels, but that's if you can fold them back and forth, you know, and get more use out of them. But one thing, you're using up time. This stuff drying, and the other thing, you're usually just get it all over your hands, and then your hands are too dirty to do any good work, too covered in stuff to do any good tweaking there. Yeah, and the more you hit that with water, the more you, I can see a big air bubble there I'm going to try to fill in. Try one more time on that corner. That air bubble. Yeah. Oh, this time. That air bubble doesn't want to fill in. And you don't want to do the put water in your sink and wipe your paper towels, you know, soak your paper towels down, rinse them that way, because it will get this junk all over your sink and it's hard to get off. Because it's latex, doesn't mean it comes off in a heartbeat. And you don't want it down the drain. I've seen people clean paint brushes in the sink and to do this in the sink, and then there, you get a lot more in your sink than you realize, and then it will stick in your drain and dry in there, and you can end up with a stopped up drain. Boy, that just wipes out every time I get near it. It's a little bit on the end of that. It's just too much water in there. So, I'm not going to hit it again until I'm going to let it dry, because I'm just getting stuff everywhere. Time to get another one. In this case, I'm going to just get the sink cleaned up, and then I'll have to come back after it's dry in a day or two and touch it up. I've done apartment maintenance. I used to be a cabinet maker, so I learned to do it the right way in new homes and remodels. And then in the late 90s, early 2000s, I did some apartment maintenance. And they wanted done quick, down and dirty and quick. So I learned some shortcuts. But, you know, you do it once and you're gone, something like that. Of course, with a new house, you know, or a remodel. Of course, with a remodel, you got customers that are going to come and look at your work as soon as you're done. So you want to do your best. You got to look good most of all. That's the whole point. So, yeah, that's all I'm going to do. I'm not going to do that top again. And let's see. But I do want to see if I can put a dab. Anyway, since this is my house, I get to come back anytime I want. I just get tired of having projects that aren't finished, waiting on me to finish them. That's the thing I don't like. Actually adding a little right there to cover up, trying to cover up my mess up where I went sanded through my gel coat to the original stuff. When I was trying to, you know, I had to cut it off, round it off, and put water on it. I had to cut it off, round it off, now I wiped it from off of there. had it where I couldn't see it. Ah, this is not easy. Okay, don't hit it again. Every time I see where I messed up something, like getting a little on the wood, I just wipe it back off. I had to cut it off, round it off, and so then I went back and sprayed. I sprayed that whole piece, you know, because it was an older scrap that I'd gotten 10 years ago or so, and it had turned yellow. This was the new one that came with this thing, but of course this, when I cut it off and then rounded it off, then of course it was down to the bare cultured marble, and so that needed to be coated and protected, and of course for looks too. So I did it, and then just a while ago I got out there and used some 400 bit sandpaper, sanded it down. Oh wow, you gotta learn when to leave well enough. I never had one of that, and now I gotta try to wipe that. Okay, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a bunch of caulking all over the wood now. Just from me touching it once with my finger. Okay, so let's squeeze this out real good. That's right there where I'd be very carefully covered that, what I was talking about. The mess up where I sanded through. You don't really want to leave that big. I mean, I kind of made a, there. Made an ugly spot. I missed. Disturbed the, it was wetter than I thought it was, and when I touched it, there, okay, that's good enough. Now, that's got some on it. Out of the bounds there. If you can catch it, you don't want to touch it a bunch. I know what I'm saying. If you keep touching it after it gets to a certain point of being dry, it will really mess up, and it can't make it look better. And I don't want to end up having to go, you know, peel it off and redo it. So, just a quick one of quick ones good. That'll be good enough to, it would be good enough, but I will probably come back and touch it up. Yeah, because it's already shrinking right now. So once it's dry and shrunk back up in there, I'll go back in a few days. When it's dry good, I'll put another bead in there. Need a caulk and let it, fill it back out just for looks. It really didn't have anything to do with how well, because the sink slopes up, so it won't have anything to do with how well it, you know, keeps the water from going back up there. But once it dries, then whatever shrunk up too much, I'll fill it in. That'll be all right. That's good enough. Like I was saying, it's way better than you might see. I was lucky enough to work for a guy that liked to do real good work, and I like to do good work. Most people just want to wham bam, thank you man, and get the money, steal them away, and get gone. They don't care what it. We used to say all the time for a joke, we used to say, looks good for my house, and that's something that we trying to get right, and we couldn't get it quite right. But our shop really cared for the most part. You know, there's always those times when you're pressured to be in a hurry or you're tired and just tired of screwing with it or something. But busy, got a lot to do in one day. When we're busy, I've done as much as I used to install cabinets too that we built, and installed as many as 3 sets in a day. That's a long, long day. But then you've also gone where you're waiting a month or two or three to for a house to be ready. You got them built up ahead of time. And you're just hoping you're going to run out of work all together. And then we did it. So, my fingers still got
close-up camera. I'm starting to call my other, all three identical phones, but I always use one for making close-ups and then have one on the tripod. That's my plan I've got going here now. So we'll make a little close-up of that. If I'd ever get around to it, I could edit all these together and make nice videos, but I'd never get around to it. I actually haven't got any uploaded in a long time. All right. On here. Okay, so there's my new sink with the new side splash, and that's the big black backsplash, extra backsplash. See, the sink has one built in, and then I made another one because I messed up, made the cabinet too deep when I made that new cabinet. Rather than cutting, it was all completely finished, and I had finished every inch of it front to back underneath because I didn't want water to ruin it. Like what? That's what happened to the last one. I built these originally about 98 or 99. So, this splash actually came with the sink, but I had to, of course, it was the length of the sink, and you have to cut it off because it can go right or left, and it already had that nice radius to fit with the sink. So I had to cut it off, and then I had to put a new finish, try to match the finish, original finish, with new gel coat. I sprayed just the end of it there. And so I got it in, got it caulked, and it's going to shrink up a little bit, so I'm going to have to go back and hit it again. This right here, this bead, I had done that probably a month ago now, and it shrunk up a little. And I just filled it in. This one shrunk just a little, but it's all right. I'm not going to hit that again up on that top one. It's water doesn't get that high, a lot of it anyway. I get more on the side than anywhere. And that also covers where this cabinet has been refinished just like up so high. And the doors were redone, but we didn't take this one out. I rebuilt the bottom one, the vanity, and I've refaced this one and kept the same doors. I can't get back far enough. I usually stand outside the bathroom. I'm gonna get over here. I usually stand outside the bathroom and shoot from the other way, but there's a TV going and everything in the house now, so it'll just make a bunch of noise. So let me see what I can do here. Not much. So there's the bottom blend, and they're separated because they're too big. It's too big to get through the house through the doors. Top one, I just refinished the doors. The refinishing I did part of it. My brother finished it for me because my health got down, and I never was able to finish it. I was gonna take this top one out and completely redo that too, but I didn't get to. But this one, this vanity is completely new, rebuilt. The door is the only thing I reused. And I built them originally in about 98, 99. And the sink's new, you just bought that. That tall backsplash was a scrap that I got from a guy that used to do some work on new houses and stuff, and some scraps laying around. And it laid around here for 10 years, and I was actually going to put a left splash, use it to make a left splash, and I never got that done to the old sink because it didn't have any splashes whatsoever. But this one came with a left or right, whichever way you needed a splash, but you have to cut it off. So anyway, I learned how to do gel coat, and it matches pretty good, and it's not bad. I'd never done that before. I've sprayed, finish like these cabinets. Well, yeah, did I spray them? No, I didn't spray them this time. I did the first time. Actually, brushed this. I used this stuff. It used to be called Flecto Verathane. It's called, they just call it Verathane now, and it's owned by Rust-Oleum now. Used to be its own brand, Flecto Verathane. But it brushes really good. It's actually made for brushing. And I like the shiny. That's white oak, and it's no stain. And this is high gloss. They use it on boats. And I like the shiny high gloss nowadays. I used to like satin. But anyway, we're actually basically done. If you see that mirror, that's old and we need to get a new one. I always wanted to build one of those, but I haven't ever done it. No, I guess I will, since I have trouble finishing what I've done so far. So, if I open that door, then you can kind of see some of the little dark spots on that top corner and the different discoloration.
I sanded plumb through in some places, and then you could see the different colors, so I made sure I didn't do that on the outside of it anywhere. But anyway, there we go, finally. Let that dry, and then I'll probably come back and fill in. I think this right in here will probably shrink under a pretty good amount, so I'll do another bead of caulk in there. And other than that, I think it'll be all right. Right there where I tried to cover it up, but it was really hard. Cover up where I actually hand sanded with 400 grit, but I went through the finish all the way through to the little spot there. Wouldn't it be on the one that showed the bottom one? I didn't do that on anywhere else. I didn't do that. There's my, I don't know if you can see it in this light, and that's the whole point. But that, there's a line there. I can almost see it. There's my magnifying glass. The line there just makes it too. You can almost kind of see it, I think. But you can see that dark spot. That's where every time I. Yeah, that looks crappy. I don't see as good as I used to, so. No, that's just the tree. I mean, what else are you going to do? Put a little white caulk on there to try to cover that up. I don't want water soaking into it at all. I even sprayed the back side of that. Thought if water did get behind there, the caulking got old and water got behind there, it wouldn't soak into that cultured marble. Because it's really porous stuff. But the wood's more actually the biggest problem. That's what got ruined last time. The whole vanity got ruined, and so did the whole bottom side of this. Had to take it off. Can't see that. You can just see the trim between the cabinets, but had to take that side off, and I went ahead and just made a whole new face frame for it. And that's called the face frame, that part there. And the doors. I used to make doors like this and when I worked in the cabinet shop, but I don't have the tools to do that. I had a guy I knew that worked in the cabinet shop made them for me. And everything else I made. So anyway, and that originally these doors were made back in 1998-99. But they're being refinished now though. So same, you know, exact finish and color and everything. Because I liked it. All right, it's done. Bye. Okay, so you, Mr. Still camera, wide shot. I'm done with you too. Bye. Bye.